parsing, we have already gone into the bottom-up parsing. Bottom-up parsing, the main thing is that first we try to be shift reduced, but sometimes confusion is reduce conflict. That is reduce, and another is shift reduce conflict. There is no two conflict, shift conflict cannot be there. Please understand, shift conflict cannot be there because all the terminals either to shift or reduce. So there cannot be between two shift confusion, no conflict. And but whether to shift or reduce, there's conflict because whenever you are shifting to a parts, then at the top of the stack you can see a handle. Okay, then you have to take decision whether the first handle you have to be greedy enough. If you are the greedy algorithm, you know sometimes doesn't work. So if you are greedy and if you see the your stack top is handle is there, and then you have an option, you can shift or also you can reduce, then sometimes you have to again shift. So that is called shift reduce conflict. But there's no that two shift conflicts cannot be there. So either shift and reduce conflict, and another is handle is there, but it can be two rules can be fired. Okay, the maybe rule number one or rule number two. That is called reduce conflict. That is a tough one. So for that is the there the LR0 grammar will not come to help. Remember that whenever you have done the LR0 item collection and all these things, we do not look ahead what is next input. We just like a Gandhari, we put a blind eye. We just take one input and see the our stack, initially put into the stack Q0 and use the Q0 and that particular terminal. Then our action table, action and go to table will either ask shift. Definitely it can be shift, it cannot be reduced because at that time your stack doesn't contain any item, only dollar and Q0, then must be shift, and then the shift and there be which state you want. So that is it. So then the your state number also with it, upon it. So you can visualize the stack, a single stack with dollar and the Q0 upon it. At the bottom, at the end, the your star symbol should come. And in our example, we have here Q1. Q1 will be the that. So that is the reverse of top down. Initially, stack should be empty in bottom up parsing, and at the end, it will be the your star symbol S or E, whatever, and the Q1 will come. And initially, dollar at Q0. So that's it. And top down parsing, you know, remember initially you put it to the stack, and there you don't need a stack state. That is a top down parsing. That way much simpler, though no stack state information. Here basically the state information on the top of the stack will actually summarize the information within the stack what is happening. So that is, but that table LR0 is simple, but for LR1, whenever you look at only one at the input, your more number of states, your parsing table will be huge. And whenever you are reduce action, then you can have not all the rows will be filled up by R1 or R2. So, and that will give a more refined reduce action, and that will serve purpose almost all the language LR1, but the table will be the big. So here we just try this example that here it is a basically palindrome grammar. It's an odd palindrome, you can see it, and you know it's odd palindrome. It can be definitely can be determined. There be parts, not parts. It can be determined by recognized by your non-deterministic pushdown automata. It can be recognized by deterministic pushdown automata because you are giving signal that S to C. The C is a midpoint, but if you give another option, you are giving epsilon. Then it will be difficult. And if the instead of C, instead of S to epsilon, then it cannot be done by a deterministic PDF. We'll see that. But here we just see very simple grammar, and you can check the rule that these rule can be done by LL1 also. But we are just checking it. How is it if you go for LR an item collection? That initially you have to add a augmented grammar S dash to S. Similarly, whenever you go for Chomsky's, whenever the configure rules, context-free grammars rules to Chomsky's normal form. You know the Chomsky's normal, the simplest of the grammar that the computer can understand. Though any CFG grammar, if you convert to Chomsky's normal form, number of rules definitely will increase, but that will be simpler for computer for any other further action, because that is the reason you see that the questions come sometimes that if you have a n number of terminals, if you have how many reduction steps can be. So you see that in, if you see the one leaf, it can be one node, it can be, it is possible for, say, if you have a three nodes in a particular binary tree, so it can be parsed maybe two steps. So n minus one is the answer. Anyway, so we come to this, which is augmented grammar. Just start another instance to S, and the rule number one, rule number two, rule number three. Here I do say that this is the input string. This can be all terminal, and it should be, drawing should be here. It should be always left to right. So if you see LL grammar or LR grammar, that is always a left to right. Here you can see easily example that what can be, if it's in Urdu. Urdu definitely it cannot be left to right. It can be right to left. So there's some language, whatever I know, they definitely have to be right to left. There's no permission. But fortunately, for all English or like all language, even the computer programmer, all are left to right. Unlike Urdu, that you remember that. Left, and if you go for try to match S, capital S or star symbol to A1, that is a typical top-down parsing. That can be two-type, recursive, non-recursive, deterministic, that is LL1 and all this thing, you know. And the interesting part is that LR parsing, that is sometimes all books say is rightmost rules in reverse. That is, this R means not rightmost, rightmost rules in reverse. So that you have to find it. That is, and in any unambiguous grammar, if it's grammar is unambiguous, and if it is by bottom-up parsing, by LR1 parsing, there can be one and only one handle at a time. It is at a stack. It is not possible that handle can be found many times. That is one. And another is handle should always at the top. These two things you have to believe by heart, and you also experiment it whenever you come to this, that you come to the stack. This the handle will always come at the top, but even is getting the handle, there's a conflict, a reduced conflict. That is the toughest conflict. That is the reason we go for LR1, full parsing table. That is cannot be done by LR0, because LR0 never look at the input. Ever LR0 is like a blind. I suppose like a blind, says a Gandhari. It doesn't look at the input. You just take the input and matching with the stack top, and you take the decision. It doesn't take the decision what the terminal ahead. At least one. If you go for two, that parsing table will be huge. All combinatory tricks will be there. So there the action. Action means it is only terminals, and then action only you know either shift and shift to which state, shift to state, and reduce by which rule. There's some confusion. Shift to state, some books and everywhere they reduce and rule number 1, 2, 3. So that is R1 and R2, R3. That is R reduced by rule 1, reduced by rule 2, reduced by rule 3. Not reduced to that particular state. Whenever you say R1, that is not reduce and go to action, go to state 1. No, it is reduced by rule number 1. Now rule number 1, by rule number 1, the left, whenever you reduce, there must be left hand side a variable. That variable which should be put on the last stack state, and that will determine the next state by the again the table. So that one is very crucial. Whenever the bottom up parsing suddenly collapsing at the end, that portion may be confused, because after the action, after this go to whatever the reduce action, whichever the variable comes, that variable will act on the state just previous at the stack, and that the action. It may be 2-3 actions together. So let's see. But the one good thing about this, the program doesn't change, only the table will change. And another thing I must tell you, that we humans are generally, we also parse everything. Whenever we are reading newspaper, whenever we understand scene, particularly in natural language processing or video image understanding, it is not left to right or right to left, that I told again and again. It is basically we try to see which, whether any characters which is common to us, common words, common, then we try to quickly scan, that is see some common examples. If you see in a sentences, there's someone intentionally spelling mistakes are there, you can, it is not at all, you can understand the things, because the thing is that we look ahead, our human brain is not look one at a symbol, but computer can see only one at a symbol. We actually look at 2-3 symbols more than this, like this. So we generally parse not left to right or right to left, definitely not right to left, until and unless it's Urdu language, yeah, then definitely not left to right. Maybe we can parse anywhere beginning, and there we can produce some known words, and from the known phrases, from known phrases to meaning, the same is happening. The CYK algorithm that I told is a bottom-up parsing. They are trying it at any place, and is a like your dynamic programming. Like whenever you are factorial in calculation, you pull all your factorial calculation in a particular area in memory, so that next factorial you can use this. So you know that dynamic programming is much helpful for calculating this factorial calculation in typical recursive mode, and there's other use of dynamic programming. So here the CI algorithm use that, and other early parser use that. The action, I told you, the action is only for terminal, is one at a time. Go to is whenever you are getting the go to state particular, that action will be there. It will only act upon the variable, and it is only the terminals. And these are the methods. The LR0 method, you are, don't look at anything. And another thing is, whenever you are making a canonical item collection, if you see any state doesn't have mixed type of thing, final dot and not final dot, that means it cannot be done by LR0. Whenever you make a canon, you don't have to go to the parsing table. Like LL1 I have shown, you don't have to go to the parsing table. In LR0, whenever you have created your I0 to any states, I9 or 10, if you see the particular state, the canonical items have said, the final state contains only final state methods, and there is no mixture between final state and the non-final state, then it can't be LR0. Then we have to go for maybe LR1, LLR, and SLR. So that is the basic thing. So LR0 is a very basic method. You don't jump to SLR. LR0, the one characteristic is that if LR0 table, and if the grammar by LR0 method you can parse it, then definitely all the state canonical items contains only the final item. There is noise is coming. Please mute anyone, please. Yes, thank you. Please check that everybody is muted, and at the end I'll definitely take all questions. Thank you. Okay. So LR0, there will be no mixture of state, that is final one, and then definitely it can be LR0. But if there is a in a particular canon is a mixture, that means it cannot be done by LR0. So then you have to look ahead one, and then this you have to calculate, you have to see the follow of that particular variable. So you know, follow of terminal doesn't have any meaning. Fast of a terminal doesn't have any meaning. Fast of a terminal is always that terminal itself. But you always calculate the follow of all variables before that. And whenever you are trying to get the follow, you need to have fast of some of the variables. So fast and follow is a very essential method in bottom-up parsing also. And fast and follow is extensively used in LL1 parsing. So same thing. Say you all variables you just blindly calculate for LR greater than LR0 person, saying fast and follow, and then you take the decision upon the follow. So rules might differ. What is the variable follows always the dollar, because if the start symbol doesn't come anywhere on the right side at anywhere, then at least in the fast and middle, then always the dollar should be in the S or the star symbol. So the fast and follow is very crucial for SLR, LR and LLR method. Next slide. Yeah. So here this is also interesting. say LR0 always greater than LL0. So when LL0 is basically a very, very minuscule grammar. It is nowhere, LL0, you cannot walk anything. But LL1 is a powerful. Definitely LL1 is greater than LR0. I have shown the earlier diagram if it's possible. So SLR, most LR1, actually this all CFG, all the unambiguous CFG and deterministic can be LR1, and whenever it is LR1, it must be unambiguous. So it is a summarize, and the thing, the table creation in LR1 is huge. It takes time, so sometimes LALR is good enough. So that's it. I think this will be more clearer whenever, because these are the, now the, you have to distinguish between LR0 and SLR, and how to LR1, and between LR. In case of LR0 parser, it doesn't look ahead even any reduce operation. That's great. It gets the current state from the top of the stack and the production rule number from the parsing table for all correct input there, and reduces the write status by the rule. So LR0 doesn't look ahead anything, so it is very simple. Here, this is the state. I have already drawn it here. I'll send this right now. I did it right now. These are the state, how to draw the state. It is very easy. First you dot here, because dot s here, so all the s to be again to be put it here. That is the canonical items, and you see nothing to be put here. But here, from Q0, say after Q0, if you get C, goes to Q4, but it is from table, it is not visible. We draw this at the background, it will be visible there. But we try to, what are the Q0 state? Q0, this is the S comes, this is the state, that is the final state. Q1 is the final state because dot is at the main, and Q2, say if Q0, if the A comes, so it can be A dot SA, and because dot is here, so all these three rules will be there because dot is, and it is also not final state, it is very obvious. And Q3, say S to B dot S, B definitely dot before S, all the rays will be there, and also it is not final state, no dot at the end. Q4, I have already told, it is at the dot at the end, it is the final state. Q5, it is dot goes from here, say here, say Q2 to Q5 definitely can go. If the S comes here, so it dot just goes ahead, so it will be, but here dot is also not at the end, so it is not. Q5 is not accepting state, and same is for Q6, it is not accepting state, but Q7 dot at the end, dot, and Q8 at the accepting state. So dot has to be in, and one great thing is, because it is LR0 grammar, you don't have to look at what is the next input, but you can determine whether particular state is at a final state. Whenever it is a final state, it has to be reduced, okay, or it has to be accepted, no shift, case Q7, Q8 or Q4, everything you have to reduce by this, but LR0, all the rules are the rules will be the same. Then LR0 item is called complete if the dot is at the right end of the production, like alpha dot. This indicates that DFA has already seen the handle. This handle is already seen, and you see the handle is one and only one handle, a handle at the top of the stack for all parsing, LR0, LL, LR, LLR, CLR. It must be at the top of the stack. How to recognize the handle? That is the, you need a number of mode states. Interesting property of LR0 DFA is that no state is formed with both complete and incomplete items. This is very vital. So by making your table, you should, if there no mixture of complete and incomplete, then we need, then definitely LR0 is sufficient. And that is, I already told, dot at the end. And that this action it is there, it is obvious from the table. Say if you are a Q0, if the A comes, a Q0, the A comes, where you will be Q0, this is the state, A dot A, where is A dot A? Q2. So shift, the Q2 is, you are making S for shift 2, this is it. Then you are in Q0, like here, and the B comes here, yeah. So then it will be B dot SB will be here, B dot SB, because dot is here, So all extension will be there. So it's Q3. So that is the thing. It is S3. 3 is Q3. S means shift. Shift to Q3, shift to Q2. And whenever the C comes, that is here, that is great. It is C dot. And C dot means Q4. That is shift 4. It is not your say reduce 4. It is shift 4. Because you have to absorb that C into your stack first. That is shift 4. Then you, after you go shift and go to state 4, then you fire the rule number 3. It is not state number, rule number 3. Rule number 3 is S to C. Then S goes upon the Q0. So then S goes to upon Q0, it is go to state 1. So it is, if it is in 4, reduce action, the reduce action S comes, S then on 0, then it will go to 1, you go to state, that is Q1. Then you are saying the your thing is accepted. The same it can be here, Q5A dot S, it is not also not final item, not final item. Here is Q7 is the final state, Q8 is the final state. But you see the looking at the states are, you, because you don't look ahead in the, so it is no mixture. And another is that you in the LR1, then you can see you have to have a forward slash and you have a follow of that particular thing. It rules by. In case of LR0, it does not look ahead even for any reduce operation. It gets the current state from the top of the stack and the production and the rule number of the parsing table for all correct input there and reduces the write execution.